Hello all, this is Mohammad Hanif from RJU KT Basar. Once again, welcome to you in this session, in this lab session for subject digital signal processing. Today in this session, we will be writing a MATLAB code to generate a square wave generation according to Fourier series expansion. Okay, so for that one, we will be writing a one function program to generate one square wave generation, and then we will be using it for multiple times to see how we are generating the square wave. Okay, so first starting with CLC and then clear all, close all, and then first we'll be defining a function. Okay, so first we have to write output variables, so x say, and then taking one step size NTS, and then taking one N value, so which will be the frequency components to generate the square wave synthesis. Okay, so next it will be here we have to give one file name square wave gen. Okay, and here we need one input, so let's square wave gen. It will go with a T. Okay. Now first defining capital N here. So capital N will be input, enter the number of frequency components for synthesis. Okay. So now so taking a small frequency component f naught is, it would be 1 upon this input t, and writing f max, so this is allowed frequency, maximum allowed frequency will be 2 into capital N minus 1 into f naught. Okay, and then we'll try to display this maximum, what is the maximum frequency, so we'll write in the highest frequency component in hertz for synthesis is, and what is that, it will be display f max. Okay, next taking a sample frequency, sampling frequency would be, it will be maximum of taking 10,000 and this f max. So f max, let's as a defining sampling frequency here, we'll try to multiply it with 4 times with f max, whichever the maximum value here it will be assigned to fs. Okay, and then we'll try to display that what is the maximum frequency it is taking here. So sampling rate used in samples per second is, and will take display fs. Okay, now we'll define a time period. So time period also we has to match with Nyquist rate. So defining t1 is equals to 2.1 into t. Okay, and defining now step size NTS, so NTS will be starting with 0, 1 upon FS till this T1. Okay, and now we have to define the output variable. What is the output variable? We have defined as X, so writing X, and we'll define it with a series of zeros, so it will be zeros 1 comma. So what we have the what would be the length we have to take here? So length of NTS. Okay. So those many zeros will be assigned to X. Now, as we are writing a code to generate a square wave using Fourier series expansion, so we must know the formula for the Fourier series expansion of a square wave generation. So that we can see from here. So this is the formula for Fourier series expansion. So according to this, we have to write a code here. So taking the for loop and then defining a k value here, n is defined. So instead of n, I'm taking a k here. So k is equals to 1 is 2. And how many values we have to go till the infinity? But here the till we have to go up to maximum this value. So that will be capital N. Okay. Now defining x is equals to x. So as it is a sum, so just we write x plus sine. This is sine value. Okay. So sine 2 into pi into. So here the n values, you can see that all the n values are odd numbers, 1, 3, 5. So here in place of n, as we have taken k, so we have to define k as to be a odd number. So we'll write 2 into k first and then we'll subtract it with 1. So it will become negative, it will become odd number. So 2 into pi n, and then we have to multiply it with a frequency. So f naught, and then our time period, okay, NTS. NTS. And then this 1 by n. So 1 by n means again 1 by. So here it will be 2 into k minus 1. Okay. So this is it. We'll end this here. But in this program, we have not included this 4 by pi. So we'll write that value here. X is equals to 4 by pi into x. Okay. And we'll end the function program here. We'll end this. Now going to main program. So here we'll start with again, once again, the main program. So what we have to define, just we have to define a input t value. So we're defining it with another variable tp, and this will be input enter the time period of a square wave synthesis, or you can say per square wave in seconds. Okay, because it is in time period, so we'll write like this. And just we have to call this function. So taking capital S is equals to x, okay, one variable, and then in place of NTS we'll be defining it is time, okay, and then a capital N. So here we'll write give a small n, okay, and this will equals to square wave gen, right? And with what is the t here, we have tp, and that's it. And now first we have to plot, okay? So plotting, so we have to plot with what? Time respective, with respect to s. Okay, so if you plot this, we must get one sine. We must get one square wave. So depends on the capital N value, so we are going to get a output waveform. Okay, so first we'll check this. So it is asking for enter the time period. So this is the time period. So let's give for 5 seconds, and then number of frequency couple. So if I give one here, so as we are we are trying to generate a square wave, but if the frequency component is 1, that means we are putting n is equals to 1 here, so we are going to get a basic sine wave only. Okay, so let's see that. Here you can see that a sine wave, and we don't have any labels also. So here the basic thing we have to understand that as a frequency components is very small, and you can say it is just only a single one, so it is generated one. So if the frequency components here, if it is increased towards the infinity, then we'll get a exact replica of or exact shape of square wave. Okay, so that we'll see here. So we'll try to see how multiple diagrams, multiple window diagrams in the same, so that we can observe the different outputs in different harmonic values. Okay, so we'll try to change some program. So first we'll make it a subplot, and we'll try to plot four plots. So subplot, and then we'll try to give labels also, x label, time in seconds, and y label, let's say approximate value, okay, and then title is also approximate square wave. So here depends on the harmonics, as we are going to get a different shape, so we'll try to accommodate with that. So we'll say a square wave with, so we'll try to write in this like this, okay, in the square brackets. So here it will be we'll try to convert this in one to so number to string, okay, and what depends on the small n, there is a capital N, okay, so here it will be small n, so depends on this n value. So as in previous example, here we have entered number of frequency components at one, so that one will be displayed here, okay. So let's say approximate square wave with one harmonic, so one harmonic, so we have to type this here. Harmonics, okay, and so first this is the first one, so we'll copy the entire thing, or let's check it once again. So running the program, so as it is asking for enter the time period for second, so once again I'm giving 5 here, and once again I'm giving 1 here. So here you can see that this is the approximate value and time in second and approximate square wave with one harmonics. So now we'll try to use the same code from here and then paste 4 times. The second time we have pasted here, so this will be 2, and then third and fourth time, so this will be 4, and this will be third one. Okay, now we'll run the program once again. So once again I am giving 5 here, and then enter the number of frequency components for synthesis. So first one, okay, so it is generated for the all has generated, okay, some error is there, let me check. So we have not called this copy, okay, so after this once again, and after this once again, so once again we run the program 5 seconds, and then enter the number of requests of 1. So here you can see that on the first window So first with the one harmonic, and again it is asking for frequency component. So this time we'll try to increase the harmonic values. So we'll say 5 and enter. We are going to get this second value. So here you can see that 5 harmonics have been generated, and the frequency, now you can see that the shape of this one is going to approximate the square wave. As so again, once again it's asking. So here now instead of 5, now this time we'll increase this to say 25. Now you can see that the approximate value or this square wave is approximating towards the square. And then next I am trying to give 100. So now you can see this is X. Okay. So this is the thing. We can write a program from the Fourier series expansion, and using those odd harmonics, we try to see how we can generate a square wave using those odd harmonics. Hope you understand this. If any doubts, please mention in the comments. Okay, so thank you. Shutting down. Thank you.